Chew guns. Usually, if the defense likes to turtle, it'll usually take about two medics, or one medic and one really good demo man. But unfortunately, I'm not playing demo man right now. So I'm gonna get a nice flank on this this heavy, and as you can see, he goes down extremely fast. And this is a good situation for me too. I'm gonna take down the medic, of course, first, and now make my way to the heavy. I probably could have backburned him, but I resorted to the shotgun instead, and that pyro kind of just WM1'd me, and oh well, he died now, so getting back to my little perch above the second point, I guess I'll call it. I could call it a perch. But yeah, just hanging around here. I see another level 3 sentry gun now on the left side. Before they had a lot of sentry guns on the right side, so I do make note of that. That no matter where I go, there's going to be sentry guns. But our team is actually able to kill that sentry gun, and this game, a medic doesn't have Uber, so I'm not really able to do too much at this point. Epic pyro battle right now. Of course, if he goes to his flamethrower, I'm going to go to my shotgun, and usually if you're good enough at aiming, shotgun will usually overtake the flamethrower, I guess, in a pyro versus pyro battle. There is actually a little bit of an art to pyro versus pyro battles, like there. You kinda gotta, if you are ever in like a pyro flaming battle, always know who hits each other first, because if you get like the upper edge on them first, then you can continue to flame them. But if you see that that you kind of missed them with your flames for a bit, you should always run away from that, because usually it's just a a little quick contest to see who can flame each other the most. And I usually don't like it going to luck, so I'll usually run away from pyro versus pyro battles. But if I do see I have the upper hand, then I'll try to finish him off with my flamethrower instead of taking out my trusty old shoddy. But here we go, the enemy is actually already taking the second point again. As you can see, like I said, it's a very a back and forth battle here. It's kind of again cool. We have both a lot of power classes. They have resorted to an absolute ton of heavies. I think they have maybe three heavies, three engineers, so the epic turtling strat, but of course they're able to push up because they do have a medic healing those heavies, which is never nice if you are a pyro. Medic heavy combos you usually want to stay clear of unless you are able to do stuff with the back burner. If you are able to get behind the medic, that's always nice, or the heavy. As you can see there, I'm kind of screwing around with the with the chat button there. I guess when I was recording, I checked to see if the recording was going good with my fraps, and I learned that I could use the chat button while my thing was recording, so you might see me put up a few little messages there every so often. So a nice little flank or ambush there on that heavy, and the medic decided to run away when you have a back burner pyro chasing you. And if you do run away, it's good to run away with your front facing the enemy, if it is a back burner, because as you can see there, I finished him up quickly because his back was turned to me. Here we actually have a nice little pyro brigade here, three pyros. I guess they left me now. But 8 minutes left here still, kind of back and forth. It's already been 10 minutes of pyro action. I never thought that I'd make a video that was over 10 minutes of backburner. But again, it's kind of fun playing this every so often. I've actually gotten back to playing this. I actually played this without recording with the backburner, so I guess that's a step in the right direction. For me, at least. I don't know if anyone actually mains the back burner over the flamethrower, any good pyros, I guess, if there are good pyros out there. But, oh well, just rocking that. And as you can see, doing some little ninja work, acts of, I'm guessing, fury is what I'm gonna type there, yep. I'm kind of in a tough situation there, not really flaming that soldier. Kind of in a tough situation there because 6 health, there was a sentry gun around the corner, and I was able to get one soldier even though my flames seemed to just go through without harming him, but oh well. Again, going back to the second point here, team's already captured the second point, so now we're going to last, yay for us. Looks like another, they're going to try to turtle again, but whenever you do capture the second point, if you do know that they turtle a lot, it's good to push out as quickly as you can, so I'm not really going to waste any time here pushing out onto the second point as I see a pyro around the corner there. Gotta kill him, and now I'm immediately going to push out because I know they're not really going to have enough time to set up their sentry guns quite yet, trying to shotgun a sentry gun there. Now I'm just going to run blindly into it because I thought the medic would follow me, but I am able to take cover behind the little poles there and kill it. So again, if you're taking down a sentry as a pyro, it's always good to hide behind anything that you can. Low health here, and they've got their heavy brigade back, but of course we are able to capture now, and as you can see in the bottom left, victory! And just top ranking like a boss there as a backburner pyro, who would have thought? Because 60 points there in a pretty good round. So yeah, hope you enjoyed this video, thanks for watching, and yeah, please subscribe if you want to see more videos like these in the future.